We're on kind of a little island out in the cattails, just a knob. So far we've come across four or five different beds, but they're just all through here. Bed there. Going back in here. See a couple more beds under on the back side. Trying to get over to them. Now you go up in the woods, which is 80 to 100 yards that way. You won't see any deer sign, zero. No rubs, barely any tracks. I did find a couple sets of tracks, followed them out into the marsh. And this is what I came on. Just bedding like crazy. Rubs like crazy. This is where I did have a good sighting of a buck back here this year. Or last year, rather. There's a trail going up under there. It's underwater now, but there's a bed back there. There's one that's on higher ground. Another bed right here. Under that. There's rubs on everything I see. I'll poke around in here a while. I'm surprised the way the wind's going. It didn't jump any, but it could be because it's so wet. Yeah, it's a good bed there. Got beds on both sides. There's one on the other side too. Shit rubbed in there. He can sit here and see people coming in on the timber to the north. And the stuff to the south. And actually the stuff to the west as well. It'd be tough getting in on him. Keep looking here. Put my butt back on. Hands are cold. This would be access to get in here. Definitely be tough. But now we're in the cattails. I'll show you, here's another bed. Not in the cattails. Bed right there. Another bed right here. Got more up ahead of me, it looks like. And this is what I believe all this is buck bedding. According to the sign, there's rubs on around every one of these beds. Get over here, this little rub. Big rub here is a bed. It's underwater right now, but I'll show you. Get to the other side of it here. In the water. Get this. There's a bed right here. It's flooded. You can see where he's got that stuff rubbed. All this is rubbed. Right here. Got another one right here. The bed in here just rubbing on everything. Got another bed right around the corner. Right in there. All of this way. My guess is there's a bed over here by this tree. Now there's some beds over here. cattails. Some big tracks. Yeah, there's a bed right back here. See it back there. There's one there. There's another one there. Trees ahead of me. And I'll bet money that there's beds under most of them. There's a trail that kind of goes to this other timber. There's a bunch of oaks and acorns. I'm sure enough been digging right here. Coyotes or something. An old bed. Got water in it. We've had fairly wet spring. Little motorcycle over here. I've scouted it before. It's a toy. Across the creek. I don't know if there's just an old toy motorcycle laying over there. But there's a creek here that I think would allow me some access. It runs up to the road. I've scouted that over there. And I know there's beds kind of the same as they are over here. But this is kind of a look at what you got here. Straight out here. Got the lake, cattails all around, and then you start getting into this red brush. That's where those beds are. We're gonna keep following this trail here. There's a fairly sizable crossing. Another crossing the creek here. Fairly solid bottom. So I think with hip boots, I can get in here. Fairly quiet. Another big trail. Imagine there's a bed. Yeah, there's a bed. There's another one right back there. That's a better one. Let's get back to this one. This looks like a definitely need hip boots. It's got a little bit of depth to it. No bridge. You couldn't pay me enough to walk across, but up here is the other point of timber. There's some oaks. Last summer when I walked it, quite a few acorns, and there are a couple trails that head into that. But I just believe this is the main bedding right here. Explore a little bit more. Dive into this over here. I'm guessing we're going to find some more beds right up here. Drainage running through here. Yeah, I'm starting to see more rubs. Starting to get more rubs through here. especially in this, you know, you're getting close. Now there's one back in here, there's another one up here. This is the stuff I like to see. Old bed right there. Yeah, it's just broken the sign in here. There's a good bed to my left. My head in there. There's just kind of beds all through here. Then you get some of the ones you kind of know that are the primo beds. Oh, this one in here. Kind of surrounded. I'll walk the other side of this. Backtrack out here. These are the trails that come into the bedding area. It's kind of nuts. I'm gonna have to give this some time this fall for sure. I only got over here once this year. Kind of regret it now. I had a camera out and did have Two shooter bucks for sure on camera here. I had my camera back on point. Old bed. Not that. Probably a bed on the other side of this. Some rubs. Pretty cool in here. Half-ass rod, not much. This is a little thinner in here. I'm trying to look around and see if I see any congregations of rubs. A few scattered. Nothing major, but we are getting really close to the road. And I can see the road plain as day from here, but that doesn't mean much. Creek is there. It runs in over to the road right over there. I think I could get in it and wade it. There we go. Bed right there by that thing. I see some more rubs up here. Going here, cutting across. There's ag fields across the street, and I imagine that's where these are heading. We'll check this bush out. Just take a look and see. This is a really boggy ground. No, not much. Just a trail that goes across the road. Out into Ag, I'd imagine. Let's see if we can cut a trail cutting back into this. It's the kind of stuff I look for away from the woods. Guys, avoid this stuff. There's not much you can do, but man, if I could get in here quiet along that edge. I could get in a tree like that. I think I'd be in the game. I think we're about out of the bedding area. We're back to kind of where we started, so shut this thing off.